From the WYLN studios in Hazleton, Pennsylvania, WYLN Evening Edition at 5:30 starts right now.
Good evening. It's Wednesday, January 11th, 2017. I'm Ann Gownley. The entire Northeastern Pennsylvania delegation visited State Correctional Institute retreat this afternoon to meet with prison senior leadership as well as prison employees. WYLN's Aaron Harvey has more.
SCI Retreat in Luzerne County is on the list of five prisons in which two could close by the end of the year. The entire Northeastern delegation visited Retreat today with the purpose to meet with prison employees to discuss the potential closure of the facility and to learn more about the facility. Legislatures included State Senators John Udichak and Lisa Baker, along with State Representatives Gerald Mullery, Tara Tuhill, Aaron Coffer, and Mike Carroll, and Luzerne County Manager David Pedry. Representatives Karen Boback and Eddie DePaczynski were represented by legislative staff. Senator John Udichak explains what he learned today about SCI Retreat.
We met with Superintendent Mooney and his senior staff. We learned some very important information. 50% of the inmates at SCI Retreat are considered and classified as mental health inmates. That's very important. That's a unique inmate, and that requires unique security that's being supplied now at SCI Retreat that may not be able to be accommodated at another facility. So that's a strong argument to keep SCI Retreat open. We met with the staff, the workers. They're high emotions. There's a lot of uncertainty, and you interject those two factors into a correction system, that's a recipe for disaster. We shouldn't be creating uncertainty. We shouldn't be creating high emotions among the staff or the inmates. This is all over the media now, so the inmates know that there is uncertainty whether or not they're going to be shipped out of one of these facilities, or whether a corrections officer or staff are going to be shipped 100 miles away from their home here in Luzerne County.
The numbers the Department of Corrections provided with inmates and employees for the five prisons seem to be wrong.
We had a very productive conversation about some of the other numbers. I mean, that's part of the process here. When you're talking about being under the gun in 10 days to make a decision about the budget of Pennsylvania without doing your due diligence, not having all the numbers, we heard some numbers today that counter some of the numbers from the department. We want to get it right. We're all united in getting it right. We recognize we have serious budget consequences, but we also recognize that 1,000 jobs lost in northeastern Pennsylvania, an impact of $100 million, will devastate the economy of Luzerne County.
Senator Lisa Baker is calling for the General Assembly to hold a public hearing on January 23rd.
It is our belief that it should be a very open and public process. As many of you know, I've called for public hearings. The Senate Policy Committee is intending to conduct a hearing on January 23rd. It's going to be a bipartisan hearing. We want to hear not just from the communities that are affected here in Luzerne County. I also represent SCI Waymark. Great concern in northeastern Pennsylvania.
State Representative Tara Tuhill says the employees are upset that they may lose their jobs.
Targeting five prisons and saying that we're going to close two of them is shocking. It's upsetting. Obviously, the employees are very upset right now and their families. And this is something that, as legislators, we're working against. We're trying to communicate to the governor that this is not going to be positive. This is not going to save money. And right now, we're in the middle of an opioid crisis, and there's more people going into the prison system. A lot of crime is drug-driven, and we want to make sure that our communities are safe.
Governor Wolf and the Department of Corrections have just about 2 weeks to make a decision on what prison they're going to close, which will ultimately affect 1,000 employees and over 2,000 inmates. In Newport Township for WILN News, I'm Aaron Harvey.
Thank you, Aaron. Hold off on closing prisons until you're sure what the economic impact is. That's Congressman Lou Barletta's advice for Governor Wolf. Barletta also says he doesn't understand the rush. The Department of Corrections says it will pick which two prisons will close by January 26th and actually close it and mothball it by the time the fiscal year starts on July 1st. Barletta says he fails to see why it's being done so quickly. State Senator John Udichak and State Representative Gerald Mullery have said the same thing. If you used your credit card at the Taco Bell on Business Route 309 in Wilkes-Barre Township since December 1st, Check your credit card statement. 26-year-old Jerome Cratch Jr. of Wilkes-Barre was arrested for allegedly swiping at least 10 customer credit cards under the counter using a copying device. Police say he was caught on camera while working the drive-thru. Police seized the copying device as well as the computer where the credit card account numbers were being uploaded. The Special Investigations Group is investigating. If you find something on a statement that shouldn't be there, contact Township Police either by stopping in through their Facebook page or by calling 570-208-4635. West Hazleton police are on the lookout for a woman who is a person of interest in an ongoing investigation. This is the photo of the woman supplied by the West Hazleton Police Department. The female was seen driving a white sport utility vehicle. Anyone with information on her identity is asked to call the West Hazleton Police Department at 570-455-3733. All calls and information received will remain strictly confidential. Freeland's 2017 budget includes an ambulance tax. It's half a mil dedicated to the ambulance. It's a first for Freeland and highly unusual in general, though it is similar to the fire tax enacted by Packer Township 2 weeks ago to fund a contract for fire coverage with Weatherly. Mark Blasco, board chairman of the Freeland Northside Ambulance Association, said it had to pay higher wages to retain crew members. Wilkes-Barre may have a buyer for the Hotel Sterling lot. The land at Market and River Streets has sat vacant since the old hotel was demolished in 2013 and has been used as a parking lot. But at last night's City Council work session, it came out that Berkshire Hathaway Guard Insurance is looking to expand its operations and include that lot. City Administrator Ted Wamhol said the city has already applied for a $1 million state gaming grant to offset construction costs. Berkshire Hathaway Guard's existing campus is across Market Street. It's time now for a first look at our forecast. The region woke up to an ice-covered world this morning. Temperatures were just below freezing and everything was covered, and that led to a list of school delays and cancellations and a slew of accidents. But with the temperatures on the rise, what does the rest of the week have in store for us? Chief Meteorologist Joe Garbaczyk is in the Weather Center with the details. Joe?
Yeah, we definitely have the warmer air actually filtering in right now as I'm speaking, and we're going to have some warm air for tomorrow, even warmer tomorrow than it was today. But earlier, boy, tell you what, we had the icy mix across our area. Roadways were definitely not good whatsoever, but things have changed since. And like I said, we got some warm air to talk about, but it's not going to last long. I'll let you know how long with the 7 day forecast in just a few. And
thanks, Joe. Coming up next, State Senator John Udichak stopped by the WYLN studios this morning to talk about the new fiscal year, the state budget, and more on the possible prison closures. Plus, a church in Weatherly is having an event during the week of prayer for Christian unity to bring everyone together. Our Abby Piskel will have that story. More news, weather, and sports is coming your way here on WYLN. Stay tuned.
You're watching WYLN News with Ann Gownley, video journalists Mike Lula and Julie Stefanovich, Paula Degnan, Gary Perna, Abby Piskel, and Aaron Harvey. Sports with Eric DeBerardinas and John Eric Poli, and weather with Chief Meteorologist Joe Garbaczyk.
Don't make the big box mistake. Shop local and save at Grand Central in Hazleton. Get better prices than the big box store on our huge selection of furniture, mattresses, appliances, and electronics at Grand Central in Hazleton and at the Laurel Mall.
All Care Home Care, providing quality in home care since 1986. Call and see how their team of licensed physical therapists, skilled nurses, speech, and occupational therapists can provide you with exceptional service in the comfort of your own home. They also offer dietitian, home health aide, and medical social worker services. You have a choice in your health care. For safe, friendly, qualified care, call All Care Home Care today and let their team begin taking care of you and your loved ones.
Hold on a second.
Baby's coming.
Now?
Yes, now.
Call you back. Did she go to the hospital?
Just a few minutes ago.
Your wife's having the baby.
What?
The baby. Go. I got this.
You're sure?
It's what I did when I started this place.
We know what went into building your wealth. Our financial advisors put the same care into helping you craft a plan to manage it. Wells Fargo. Together we'll go far.
Don't make the big box mistake. Shop local and save at Grand Central in Hazleton. Get better prices than the big box store on our huge selection of furniture, mattresses, appliances, and electronics at Grand Central in Hazleton and at the Laurel Mall.
Welcome back to WYLN News. I'm Abby Piskel, and today I'm joined with Senator Johnny Dutek, who's going to talk to us all about the budget. So anything you want to tell me, go right ahead.
Very challenging year for the state of Pennsylvania. We're looking at a projected budget deficit of $600 million for this fiscal year and potentially a $3 billion deficit for the next fiscal year. So many challenges. Republicans and Democrats are going to have to work especially hard and are going to have to work together. They're trying to find a way to get our budget situation back under control. Big cost drivers, pensions. We need pension reform in Pennsylvania. I voted in the Senate last year and in the last few years driving pension reform. We clearly have to get a handle on that. It's one of the biggest cost drivers in the state budget and to our local schools. I mean, here in Hazleton, greater Hazleton area, their pension payment went from $2 million to $32 million. That's taking money out of the classroom. That's making it very difficult for taxpayers. We need to fix our budget problems, and it starts with pension reform.
So what types of things can people do to, like, kind of just educate themselves on the budget and anything else that they can do to kind of help things?
The governor will give his budget address in February. We will then have a series of appropriations hearings over the next 3 weeks following the governor's budget address. Pay attention to those appropriations hearings. All the state agencies come in and make their case for their budget allocation, and the governor will lay out his agenda. And as part of that, the legislators, Democrats and Republicans, will lay out their agenda in terms of what they believe we can do to get a handle of this budget crisis in Pennsylvania.
Is there anything else that you think that the governor might cut or change with his budget plan?
Well, the governor has laid out a proposal, an initial proposal, to cut prisons. We're going to talk about that. Three of them are in northeastern Pennsylvania, Frackville, Waymart, and SEI Retreat in the 14th Senatorial District. I think that's a short-sighted plan. I'm opposing that plan. The one agency that has been aggressive at cost-cutting has been the Department of Corrections. Over the last 5 years, they've saved $142 million. There's 1,000 less employees in the Department of Corrections than there were 5 years ago. So one agency that's been very aggressive at cost-cutting is Corrections.
Now, I know the prisons are a pretty big deal. We had spoken to you the other day about it. What else can you kind of tell me about that? I know, like, I think 2 out of 5 are planning on being closed.
But one of the problems that I have with the governor's announcement is that he plans to decide in 10 days to close 2 prisons. We haven't fully vetted that decision. It's not being driven by cost savings, because that cost savings won't be in this fiscal budget or next fiscal budget. So clearly this is being a politically motivated decision. We need to take the politics out of it. We need to do our due diligence, work with our federal partners. If there's a way the federal government can save money on their end in terms of not having to build federal prisons and they could house those inmates in Pennsylvania, that's what we should be looking at, those kind of cost-cutting measures.
You're a senator, you have a seat of power. Are there any plans of action that you plan on taking to help anything?
The only power that I have is the power that's given to me by the good people in northeastern Pennsylvania, and their voice is what really matters. I'm their vehicle, I'm there for their voice in Harrisburg. They need to get engaged in this process. We're fighting for northeastern Pennsylvania. We're talking about the potential loss of 1,000 jobs and $100 million impact to our negative impact to our economy. Simply unacceptable. We're going to have to fight this together as a family, with state workers, with taxpayers, because just looking at SEI Retreat in Newport Township, there's going to be over $1 million hit to that local economy. That's to the school districts. So the governor says he's for schools, but that's going to drive $700,000 out of the schools represented in Luzerne County because of that closure. 315 people are going to lose their job in Luzerne County, going to be shipped to another part of the state. A devastating, devastating impact to our local economy. If SEI Retreat at $57 million impact on that community, it's just going to be devastating if we lose those jobs, if we lose that economic impact here in Luzerne County.
Senator, it's 2 weeks into the new year with new members of the House and Senate. What can Pennsylvanians expect from our government this year, especially with the large budget deficit and the cuts across the state?
Well, there's a lot of new members, and most of them are Republican. This is the largest Republican majorities in over a century. 34 Republicans in the Senate, 121 Republicans in the House. I've always marked my career by in a bipartisan way by working together across the aisle. That's not, unfortunately, the way Harrisburg has worked the last few years. Unfortunately, what we saw 2 years ago was a manufactured crisis in our schools driving the budget discussion, and I think we're seeing that played out again by the administration in a manufactured crisis in our correction system in driving a policy agenda with the budget. So more Republicans, a kind of a new look to the General Assembly, a divided government. It's going to be harder, but now more than ever, those of us that can reach across the aisle, that can work together as Democrats and Republicans and fight for Pennsylvanians, fight for the taxpayers of Pennsylvania, that kind of attitude, that kind of outlook is needed now more than ever in Harrisburg.
Well, Senator, I certainly want to thank you for taking the time out of your busy schedule to talk to me today, and I certainly wish you the best of luck as we go forth with the new year. Stay tuned. More news is coming your way here on WYLN.
Lehighton Kia for your new or used car, truck, or SUV. They showcase a variety of vehicles like the Kia Rio, an eye-catching Cadenza, the sporty Optima, or Soul, the Forte lineup, along with the Sorento and Sportage with a bold array of features. And stop in to see the all-new subcompact Niro, a hybrid utility crossover vehicle. Ask about specials and incentives, and you can't beat the 10-year, 100,000-mile warranty. Lehighton Kia, 21 Blakesley Boulevard in Lehighton. Call them at 610-377-1570.
Story's a glorious story, the sweetest that's ever been told. They found they were handy at making fine candy for family and friends to behold. Word spread through the land that Victoria's candies would one day be leading the rest. Now that day is here, for the facts are quite clear that Victoria's candies are best.
Well, the ice that we had across our area earlier today, a lot of it has melted with those temperatures getting above freezing, upper 30s, lower 40s. And tomorrow, it's even going to be warmer yet. We'll be looking at temperatures in the mid to upper 40s, with some areas the potential of reaching near 50 degrees. And again, tonight, still a chance of a little bit of some rain even into tomorrow morning. But temperature-wise, again, it's going to continue to stay above freezing, and tomorrow's temperatures are going to be well above where they should be for this time of year. After that, though, it's going to get a little bit colder across our area. So today we did pick up about a tenth of an inch of precipitation since the midnight hour, and those temperatures are looking like this, 40 degrees. And we have a bit of a wind out here, but when you get temperatures near 40 like it is now, it's not nearly as bad when you get the wind versus when you have temperatures in the teens when it's feeling like it's single digits or below zero. So overall, hey, you know what? Not too bad for this time of year, and even better temperature-wise for tomorrow. So how did we do for the high and for the low for the day? Well, pretty nice for this time of year. We are in January, 44, and at 27 occurred right at midnight, because since then temperatures started to go up versus down. All right, throughout the state of Pennsylvania, temperatures have warmed up nicely. Temperatures in the 40s, and look at down by Philly, temperatures actually in the lower 50s, and even in the lower 50s in Erie and in Pittsburgh. The wind's generally averaging between 5 miles per hour or so not too bad across our area. So we have the potential of a little bit of some leftover morning rain or some showers for tomorrow morning. And after that, we start to clear things out on a 7-day forecast. And it'll be about 47 degrees, 34 for tomorrow night. And then we're only going to be in the 30s. The temperatures will drop going into Friday, 15 Friday night, Saturday, Sunday, not looking too bad. Saturday should be the coldest. Probably won't get out of the 20s, but then we're in the 30s for Sunday and Monday, And then look what happens as we start going into Tuesday and Wednesday of next week. Back up into the 40s for daytime high temperatures. Not bad for January. We'll have more for you coming up after the break.
Now open Chevrolet's Auto Service in their new location, 1099 Hanover Court in Hazel Township. They do it all, brakes, exhaust, electrical, and more. Four-wheel alignment, $39.99. Both inspections, just $39.99. Oil and filter, $19.99. 50-pound rock salt, $5.99. All-season tires at a great price. They treat you right and save you money with great prices and great service. Is your engine light on? Stop in for a free diagnostic computer check. Get your vehicle ready for winter. 570-455-4286.
Chura's Auto Sales has a great line of cars and trucks. Every vehicle is serviced, reconditioned, and inspected. Chura's Auto Sales offers you experience, quality, and service. Stop in today, North Broad Street and Susquehanna, West Hazleton.
Your body was made to move fluidly and with ease. If the need for joint replacement surgery has stopped you in your tracks, it's time for a plan that can put you back in motion faster. The area's most experienced surgeons. The region's only nationally ranked program. That's orthopedics in action at Lehigh Valley Health Network.
Northeast Gold and Silver inside the Churchill Mall is paying cash for gold and silver. Top dollar for silver coins, national currency, fine and sterling flatware. Stop in or call them at 570-497-4177.
A special event to celebrate a week of prayer will be held at one church in Weatherly, and all are invited to attend. WYLN's Abby Piskel has the details.
The week of January 18th through the 25th is known as the Week of Prayer for Christian Unity. The Weatherly Ministerium at Our Lady of Lourdes Church, located in Weatherly, is hosting a special event on January 22nd at 3 p.m. to celebrate Christian Unity. The event is free and open to the public and will have Christian prayer and free materials that can be used throughout the week of prayer.
We'll be presenting a program, we'll be reading scripture, we'll be sharing on that particular day. There'll be materials handed out, programs, prayers that can be said and meditated on throughout the week. So please join us here on Sunday, January 22nd at 3 p.m.
This event has been around since 1908, but this is the first time in recent years that it will be celebrated in Weatherly.
The event itself is brand new to our community, so we're encouraging people to come out and get the materials and read the scriptures that are outlined there and meditate on some of the thoughts. This year being the first year that we're utilizing these materials, were developed by church members in Germany. Usually each year a country does a look at Christ in unity and comes up with some material. So here in 2017, they were developed by the churches of Germany.
With all of the different Christian groups in the area, this event is a great way to bring everyone together to celebrate the Week of Prayer.
We have so many different Christian groups in our community that the Weatherly Ministerium talked about and agreed that this would be a great event for our community.
Again, the event will be held on Sunday, January 22nd at 3 p.m. at Our Lady of Lourdes Church, located in Weatherly. For WYLN News, I'm Abby Piskel.
Thank you, Abby. Coming up next, Eric DiBerardinas is in with sports here on WYLN. Plus, Chief Meteorologist Joe Garbaczyk will have one final look at our forecast. Stay tuned.
It's Owner Appreciation Month at Burger, Chrysler, Jeep, Dodge, Ram, Route 93, Hazel Township.
It's Owner Appreciation Month. Lease this Ram 1500 four-wheel drive for only $295 a month. Lease the new Pacifica for only $295 a month. Your choice of a Renegade or a Compass for only $23.9.
It's Owner Appreciation Month at Burger, Chrysler, Jeep, Dodge, Ram, Route 93, Hazel Township.
Burger Family Dealerships, drive with experience.
Connects Janitorial Service, carpet cleaning, tile, linoleum, hardwood floor refinishing. Also, office and home cleaning for dependable service. Call Connects Janitorial Service, 570-788-2748.
Sal's Septic Service for cesspools and septic tank cleaning, and Marola's Garage for car and truck inspection and repairs. If it has wheels, Marola's can fix it. Call Sal's Septic and Marola's Garage at 570-956-4782.
From East 11th Street in Hazleton to 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue in Washington, D.C., just part of the journey for Joe Maddon. When the Cubs won the World Series in November, President Barack Obama invited the team to make the customary championship White House visit while he was still in office. And Chicago was going to take him up on that offer because, well, duh. When Maddon and the Cubbies will be at the White House on Monday, Obama's last week as president. The plays have been limited with cancellations due to weather, but no delays in plays of the week. Berwick has been balling here at the Pretty Dime, from Matt Champ to Alec Markle. Style points there. A sloppy start to this one. Valley West's Mike Frace gets it back, though, to Craig Ruff, behind the back bounce dish, and lefty finish. And this is becoming a common occurrence, but still nice. Hazleton's Jeff Planudis slamming on the break, and we're waiting for that shattered backboard. And we finish with not a play, but just the sight of someone back on the court after being diagnosed with prostate cancer in the offseason and taking a leave of absence. Panther Valley head coach Pat Crampsey made his return to the bench on Monday. We want to say keep fighting to Pat. And local hoops postponed. Again, since we can't be at MMI tonight, we'll update you on the boys' basketball season to this point. No longer guaranteed a district playoff berth, the Preppers are 2-7 so far, while mixing in both young and old talent. First halves have been fine, second halves, not so much.
What do we have to change? Is it something we do at halftime? Is it something, you know, we need to do better getting kids breaks in the first half? Just all that kind of stuff.
Some lack of depth, I'd say. And also a practice, maybe just not everyone pushing themselves 100% and, you know, sprints and everything get a little bit tired in the second half. But.
Tomorrow it's live wrestling on WYLN. At 7 o'clock we will broadcast a big Wyoming Valley Conference match between Hazleton area and Tunkhannock. We'll preview that one tomorrow. For now, that's it for sports. Stay tuned.
Graziano's Restaurant offers casual dining with a menu that will please your appetite. Everyone enjoys Graziano's. Join the crowd, have fun, and enjoy a fabulous dining experience. They have a full menu to choose from, catering for up to 40 people. Special orders are accepted. Located at Rose and Hazel Streets, Beaver Meadows. Call them at 570-455-9116.
Physical therapy and balance centers. It's spelled different because we are different. Physical is unlike any therapy center you've been to before. If you're tired of living in pain, if you want to move better, overcome an injury or balance disorder, or you just want to improve your strength and conditioning, our highly skilled team of medical experts will help you get back to living the life you enjoy. New mentality, new body, new life. Get physical.
Modern Therapeutic staff take pride in providing quality care in a professional setting. In-home care for homebound patients and provide free transportation to and from our location. Modern Therapeutics, 1109 West 15th Street, Hazleton.
I'm Gary Perna. I was born and raised here in Clare, Schuylkill County. I'm proud to be a part of the WYLN team, and I'm excited to be part as WYLN brings communities together through the power of television.
40s for tomorrow, some areas near 50 degrees, maybe a little bit of some leftover morning rain, but other than that, temperature-wise, can't get that better for this time of year. Then we're in the 30s for Friday. Coldest day will probably be Saturday. In the 20s, back up in the 30s for Sunday and Monday. And then look at that, 40s again for Tuesday and Wednesday. That's okay. because it's January, and you get a couple of those cold days. I'm all right with that, and followed by some warmer weather. I'm okay with that, too.
Yeah.
And I'm okay with one closer day to spring.
What are you not okay with?
Yeah.
We won't go there.
Lots of snow. I'm going to go with that.
Well, I think all of us had a long process today with the ice on our
cars.
Yeah,
that was some thick ice.
That was. It was. And luckily, the weather warmed up. We didn't have to worry about it too much.
No, just the morning. Yeah, it was very
slick. Those leaving early in the morning, I have to say there was a lot of ice on there, a lot of time.
A lot of time to clean off the car.
It was.
It definitely was.
But hopefully everyone got to where they were going safely this morning and continues throughout winter. Have a good night, everyone.